Hi, I'm Parker from the Surface Duo Developer Experience team. In this session, I'm going to talk about automated testing for Android apps and about how you can write tests specifically for dual screen and foldable device layouts. Automated testing, run as part of continuous integration, helps keep app quality high by revealing potential issues as soon as the code is checked in. This can include unit tests, which validate code functionality, and UI tests, which evaluate screen elements and layouts to ensure the user interface works as expected. Today, we're focusing on UI testing for Android apps. To put this all in context, first I want to introduce the Surface Duo, and then talk a little about test frameworks and how to write tests for an arbitrary screen, regardless of the type of device. Then, we'll look at additional considerations for testing dual screen and foldable devices. Finally, we'll bring the pieces together to write a UI test that evaluates if a dual screen feature is working as intended. By using these techniques, you can confidently enhance your Android apps with foldable features and rely on your CI system to ensure that each new release continues to work well without lots of tedious manual testing on a variety of devices. The Surface Duo is a dual screen device that runs on Android. It comes pre-installed with a suite of Microsoft apps, and it has access to a large catalog of apps and games in Google Play. Applications open on a single screen by default, and two applications can run side by side, one on each screen. You can also drag an app to fill the entire display, which maximizes screen space but places an area of the app across the hinge. We're going to use these different postures to test app scenarios, but first let's take a quick look at the types of experiences that you might build and test for on Surface Duo. This slide shows five common user experience design patterns that might be appropriate for your apps. Expanded canvas uses the entire screen area for a map, drawing a canvas like whiteboard or a spreadsheet like Excel. List detail uses the two screens to provide drill-down navigation for lists of images or data, such as an email inbox like Outlook. Two-page is best suited for reading books and comics, as it uses the two screens like pages in a book. Dual view displays multiple views of the same information, like an address list and a map with pins. And finally, companion pane, which adds extra controls, like an image effects palette or game controller, to the second screen. Xbox Game Pass uses this to provide a full-screen gaming experience on top, with customized game controllers on the bottom screen. To implement these dual-screen and foldable-specific user experiences, your code will need to understand details about the device it's running on, such as if a hinge is present and whether it's partly folded. The Jetpack Window Manager package from Google provides this information. Each time the device posture or layout changes, a message is sent to update the position of the hinge so the application layout can adapt. Now that we've learned a bit about Surface Duo, let's switch back to the topic of testing. There are three Android testing frameworks to consider. Espresso, which provides APIs to write tests that simulate user interactions in an app and query for the results of those actions. Espresso works with Android views, and tests can be written in Kotlin or Java. Jetpack Compose testing APIs are the equivalent of Espresso for composables. And finally, UI Automator. Espresso and Compose testing operate specifically on a single app. For cross-app functional testing, such as opening settings or interacting with the launcher, UI Automator provides APIs to interact with the test device or emulator. This will come in handy when we want to span an app across both screens. Regardless of the testing language and the complexity of the test, there are three important parts to consider. Firstly, the setup. This means ensuring that the state before the test is correct so that the results will be valid. It could be as simple as starting the app, or a complicated set of steps that establish a specific state in the app by querying elements and simulating user actions to get the view into the required starting state. Secondly, taking the actions that you are testing. Test code can check the state of the app by looking for the existence of controls on the screen, or for the value of control. Thirdly, asserting that the feature being tested worked as expected by inspecting elements on the screen. Let's start with an Espresso test, targeting a regular Android phone. The code is written in the Android test project in Android Studio, and when executed, runs along with the target, simulating user interactions and inspecting the results. This snippet shows an extremely simple test, consisting of only two pieces of code targeting an XML layout. The first line defines the screen to be tested, which will be the main activity. The second piece is a function that contains a simple query that verifies the screen is displaying a specific string, app text. The annotations expose these elements to the testing framework to be executed manually in Android Studio or as part of an automated test run. When run, It'll pass if the expected string is on the screen, and it'll fail if not. This slide shows a roughly equivalent test, but this time targeting Jetpack Compose. There's one additional line required, which sets the composable to be tested. The main activity is still the screen being tested, and the query checks for the same app text being displayed. Just like the Espresso version, when run, it will pass if the expected string is on the screen, and it will fail if not. Using these simple building blocks, complex tests can be constructed which check for elements on the screen, simulate user interactions such as input and navigation, and verify the next screen is what you expect. As I mentioned earlier, UI Automator is for driving things outside of the application being tested. Examples include navigating through the launcher, interacting with the Settings app, or for Surface Duo, dragging the app handle to span it across both screens. These are actions that the Espresso or Jetpack Compose test frameworks can't accomplish. I'm not going to go into the details of UI Automator syntax because the Surface Duo team has wrapped up useful functions into the Surface Duo test kit. Rather than deal with the UI Automator directly, you can use a UI device class to perform actions like spanning or unspanning an application between one and two screens, as this code snippet shows. Now I'm going to switch over to Android Studio and walk through a simple dual-screen app with UI tests. Starting in the project window, the sample has been written in both Compose and Views XML. Let's take a look at the Compose code. MainActivity.kt contains our sample app. It's a simple fold-aware demo that uses the two-pane layout control from the Surface Duo team. As I scroll down, you can see the two-pane definitions include text elements that contain strings pane 1 and pane 2. We'll use the presence of these strings in our tests to understand what is being shown on the screen. The actual test methods are in the Android test folder. When I open the Compose test Kotlin file, you can see that unlike the application code, the class and individual functions have a run option in the gutter. This means you can interactively execute a test or a suite of tests to build and debug them from within Android Studio. There is some setup required for our tests. Firstly, you can see the Compose test rule is created using the main activity class. There is also a device instance created, which uses the UI device class from the Surface Duo test kit. This provides APIs to perform UI automator steps to span and unspan applications on the dual screen devices. Now it's time to run the first test. Because tests run and tear themselves down, I'll put a breakpoint on the assertion line so we can watch it execute. The code simply sets the composable that we want to test and then verifies that the string pane 1 is displayed on the screen. When I hit continue, the test will complete and show as green in the results tool window. The second test is designed to verify that the second pane is shown on a dual screen device, so I'll switch to the Surface Duo emulator. This code has multiple steps. First, it sets the composable and verifies that the pane 1 string shows as expected. Then it uses the UI device class from TestKit to span the app and does more assertions, this time checking for both pane 1 and pane 2 strings. I'm going to put two breakpoints in and then debug the test. Before spanning, the first assertion will be true, and when we continue, the UI automator code will kick in and simulate a drag action that will span the app. The next assertions will then check that the two strings are now visible, and if so, the test will pass green. More sophisticated tests can be built up from these basic steps. You can simulate more user interactions such as text entry or button presses, and assert various states to confirm the screen is updated as expected. TestKit and UI Automator can help with foldable interactions in other scenarios. That's all I have to show you today, but I'll leave you with these thoughts. Being able to repeatedly test your app user interface can give you confidence that as you make changes over time, key functionality continues to work. This includes writing tests that check for adapting to different devices and screen sizes. If changes made to a screen or layout inadvertently break a usage scenario under certain conditions, then these tests can help catch the bug before it makes it to your customers. UI Test and UI Automator provide the foundations to write tests for both simple and complex scenarios, and the Surface Duo Test Kit adds dual-screen specific helpers like the ability to span the app. Automated testing is a great strategy for maintaining app quality, and adding tests for form factors like dual screen and foldable devices means you can be sure your customers continue to have a great experience as your app and the device ecosystem grows. If this session has inspired you to start adding UI testing to your Android apps, visit developer.android.com/testing to learn more about UI testing with Espresso, UI Automator, and Jetpack Compose. To add Surface Duo tests to your app, visit our test kit on docs.microsoft.com. The test kit package contains helper methods to make testing easier, regardless of whether you use Android views or Jetpack Compose as your UI framework. And finally, if you're interested in learning more about dual screen design patterns and enhancing your app for foldable devices using Jetpack Window Manager, visit docs.microsoft.com/dual-screen. We have documentation, code examples, full sample apps, and more for Kotlin, Java, and cross-platform frameworks such as Flutter, Xamarin, React Native, and the web. Thanks for joining. I hope you enjoy the rest of Microsoft Build 2022.